Hello, my name is Brad Jenks, and I'm a voice teacher in Chicago. Welcome to the first of what I hope to be a series of videos on the subject of singing. Once upon a time, I used to keep a blog much more regularly, but I'm afraid raising my voice keeps me so busy that I'm not always able to sit down and find the time I'd like to write. So I decided that maybe it'd be a little faster and a little bit more user-friendly for people who are interested in these ideas to, you know, click on a video. So the driving force behind both my blog and these videos is really philosophy of singing. There's some practical application as well, but the general idea being that how you think about it is going to be how you proceed and how you practice. So the first thing that I thought I would offer is something that's been on my mind a good deal recently, and it sort of gets at the heart of many of the things that we deal with, not just in singing generally, but in studying singing, learning how to. And that is that singing happens in a particular way, in a particular order of physical events, but our perception of singing very often happens the complete reverse. Specifically, what I mean is that when you're singing, you draw in a breath, you then breathe that back out. So body, torso, breath, exhale, and then you phonate with that. You make a sound, and then in here, in your vocal tract, you give shape to that sound, and resonant questions are answered or raised, and then the sound leaves you and it is no longer in your control. So step one, step two, step three, gone. But when we're perceiving our singing, when we find our mind on the singing that we're doing, usually it happens, as I said, the complete reverse. We hear the sound that we've made and we judge it. We go, I didn't like that, or that was pretty good. Or we simply hear the sound with our ear, the sound that's already left us, and then we do an assessment. If we stumble, if we trip over our words, whether in conversation or in song, we find ourselves going, ugh, I can't believe, what did I say? And we check our articulators, we go, oh, we become suddenly aware of the shaping that we've done. So we work back to here. Maybe at the end of a long day of teaching, or at the end of a long day of singing, or something awkward that we've done vocally that left us uncomfortable, we suddenly become aware of the sound as we've made it. And we go, that didn't feel very good. My throat's tired. My voice feels really, you know, fatigued. And suddenly we've worked our way back to here. And then sometimes, not even terribly often, we work our way back to breath. And if you listen carefully, 9 times out of 10, your average singer or person is going to say something that is much more related to their breath in, to their inhale. They will say things like, oh, sorry, I didn't get a good breath. Or if I'm gonna sing that phrase, I'm gonna need a bigger breath. Or hold on, let me try, I gotta mark in my breath. But very often, they completely ignore the exhale that is the primary constitutive element of their sound. So at every stage of the way back, we become less and less focused on its role. And what I've been encouraging my students, and you know, anybody who reads or listens, to think is that, in fact, maturity in singing, maturity in orating, maturity in anything vocal, specifically the practice of anything vocal, is bringing your thinking and your practice in line with how singing happens, which means reordering your priorities and your attention to the order in which vocalism happens. And when we do that, we have healthier priorities and usually a better result. I hope this helps you. And if you enjoyed it, please tune in for more. Have a great day.